Hey, this is Tony with Salt Strong, and in this video, I'm going to do an underwater comparison showing four different profiles of paddle tail or swim bait lures underwater and sort of helping you determine, you know, which one you should be using under certain conditions based on the type of action that the lure gives off. So we're going to look at this action underwater, have some underwater footage of four different types of lures here. I'm going to show you which ones here. This is our 5-inch Bomber Slam Shady paddle tail. This is our custom paddle tail from Salt Strong. Also, we have the Slam Shady 2.0. We're going to be looking at that one underwater. Then we have some Z-Man baits. We have the Z-Man Paddler Z. We're going to show that one rigged up and the action underwater. And then also the Minnow Z. Now, I'm also going to have all four of these lures rigged up on the same hook for, you know, consistency. So I'm using a 4-aught 1/8 ounce owner twistlock hook. That's what I'm gonna have these lures rigged up on. So let's go ahead and take a look at the underwater footage and do an analysis of each of these lures and their action underwater. So first up is our Slam Shady Bomber paddle tail. This is a 5-inch paddle tail. It has a larger tail section on it, you know, a larger paddle, so it gives off a good amount of vibration. So excellent lure in very murky conditions or windy conditions to help draw attention to those fish. Now the tail section is a little bit thick, so you do have to have, you know, either a good amount of current or also a little bit of a faster retrieve to get that tail kicking, because as you can see here, I was doing a very slow retrieve with no current and the tail wasn't really getting any kicking action. So that's one thing really important to consider when you're choosing which paddle tail to use is, you know, if you're retrieving your lure with the flow of the current, there's not going to be as much resistance against that tail. So if you're using a lure that has a thick, you know, tail section that requires more resistance to get kicking, you may want to switch to something that's a little bit thinner. Now lastly, with the Bomber is when you're bouncing it along the bottom, pretty much all the paddle tails that I tested in this video had a really good action when bouncing, you know, along the bottom. Some have the tail kicking when it's sinking down. As you can see, the Bomber doesn't have the tail kick too much. I was using a 1/8 ounce weight, but if you went with a heavier weight where that lure would dive down faster, it should definitely get that tail kicking. Now next up we have the Slam Shady 2.0. This is a smaller paddle tail, you know, 3.5 inch size. Also, it's a little bit of a softer material. The tail section leading up to the paddle is thinner, so you get a lot of kick out of this lure, even when you're retrieving it really slow, which I really like about this one. Also, when you bounce this lure either, you know, in the middle of the water column or along the bottom, when you bounce it up, you know, as it's going up, the tail kicks, and as it's going down, the tail kicks as well. So you get a lot of strikes on this lure as it's falling because of that tail kicking as it's descending down to the bottom, almost like a dying bait fish. And now, because of the versatility of this lure, you know, you can bounce it, you can retrieve it fast, you can retrieve it slow. It's in that prime size, you know, that 3.5 to 4 inch size. I like to use this lure under various conditions, you know, clean water, dirty water, windy conditions, low light, sunny days. It has excelled very well under all those conditions. Next lure up is the Z-Man Paddler Z, or the Paddlers. This lure has a very skinny tail section, so it doesn't give off as much vibration. So if you have some fish that are very finicky or very skittish, this would be a great lure choice in murky water or clear water. But if I had to choose, I would mainly throw this in clean water because you don't want as much action and as much vibration as some of the other paddle tails, especially like the Slam Shady Bomber, which has a very large tail section that thumps a lot. Now, what I saw excels really well with this paddle tail in particular is when you twitch this lure. Because it's Z-Man material, it sinks very slowly, so you can do a slow, aggressive twitch, if that makes sense, and get a really good action out of this lure, almost like a combination between a jerk shad and a paddle tail. And to view this lure bouncing along the bottom, again, that buoyant material made by Z-Man, that Elastec, it sinks very slowly, and when it does hit the bottom, it almost stands on its head for a while. So that can be really good to get a fish's attention, especially if you're fishing in grass or some structure on the bottom where you want your lure to stick up when it hits the bottom. Now next up is the Z-Man Minnow Z, or the Minnows.
As you can see, very standard type of paddle tail lure. Again, it is that Z-Man material, so it's gonna be more buoyant. So you may have to go a little bit heavier on the hook when you are using these to get the same sort of depth control as other soft plastics. And this is another paddle tail that I would use in various conditions, you know, murky water, clean water. It's very similar to Slam Shady 2.0, where you can retrieve it at a pretty good pace and also a very slow pace to get that tail kicking. And then as far as, you know, like a twitch pause or a bouncing retrieve, I noticed a slight difference from Slam Shady 2.0 is that when this lure sinks, it doesn't really have that tail kicking action. It's not as consistent as a Slam Shady 2.0. You can see it well in this clip here. As it descends down to the bottom, it sort of spirals instead of having the tail actually kick on the way down. But also keep in mind, I was using the same amount of weight for all these lures. Because Z-Man lures are more buoyant, you may have to go with a heavier weight to get that lure to sink faster, more resistance on the tail to get that tail kicking.
So I hope you enjoyed this video. You know, all paddle tails are not created equal. They all have a very different action. Some of them just slightly different than the others, but that can be the make or break between getting a fish to strike or not. So hopefully this video can help you out in determining which one you should use based on different conditions. And if you are interested, we do sell all these lures on our shop page at fishstrong.com. You can pick some up. And if you're one of our insider members, keep in mind you do get up to 20% off everything on the shop page. So definitely be sure to take advantage of that. Until next time, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.
If you're new to Salt Strong, just know that we're the best online fishing club in America because we actually guarantee that you'll catch more fish while saving time and also money on the tackle you need. We do this through premium education, our exclusive insider fishing community, and huge discounts on the best tackle for saltwater anglers. To learn more, go to saltstrong.com. Otherwise, we hope to see you again soon.